This is the SAP Developer News for December 19, 2024.
Just want to let everybody know about the upcoming plans for the Developer News as we take our annual end-of-year break. This is the last regular news episode that we'll have for 2024. And like the previous years, we have special year-in-review episodes coming up for the last week of December and the first week of January. So you hear from each of the team members about what they reflect upon 2024, their major accomplishments, things that they've enjoyed, all those sort of things. And be on the lookout for our special bloopers. We'll throw some fun, exciting bloopers in at the end of each of those episodes and probably release that separately as well. So we look forward to seeing you back here for new episodes the second week of January 2025.
SAP Cloud SDK for AI is our official software development kit for SAP AI Core, SAP Generative AI Hub, and Orchestration Service. The JavaScript TypeScript version was introduced 2 months ago, and last week we released version 1.4. This new version adds support for the Orchestration Service's grounding capabilities. Grounding allows you to integrate external, contextually relevant, domain-specific, or real-time data into your AI processes. This data supplements the natural language processing capabilities of pre-trained models, which are typically trained only on general datasets. Additionally, the Java version of the SDK has reached a significant milestone with the release of version 1.0, bringing numerous new features and enhancements. You can find the complete documentation and sample projects in the Git repository. For Python users, the Generative AI Hub SDK has recently released version 4.1.1, which introduces support for prompt registry templates in orchestration. Are you feeling overwhelmed by all this terminology? No worries. If you are new to AI or wondering how SAP is embedding AI into our portfolio, check out the recent post by my teammate Nora. She guides you through relevant courses and activities available on SAP Learning. Links are provided in the description.
If you've ever wanted to gain a deeper understanding of CAP, learn more about its design and the fundamental core computing building blocks upon which it's based, then we've got a series for you. On the Hands-on SAP Dev Show, which we've been running since early 2019, we've got a new mini-series with none other than the creator of CAP himself, Daniel Hutzel. The series is called The Art and Science of CAP, and in each episode, Daniel takes us on journeys deep and wide, bringing enlightenment and wonder in equal measure. Now, the series was kicked off during Devtoberfest 2024. It's still running. There's an episode or two to go. And alongside the episodes, the live stream episodes, there are also show notes that you can dive into afterwards, or you can just watch the replays of the live streams and dive into the show notes as well. There's a ton of stuff to explore and learn about. So, this holiday season, treat yourself to some amazing insights and check out the episodes that we have on offer along with the accompanying notes. And we'll see you online.
Hey, y'all. If you're a developer working with SAP UI5, you'll want to check out this blog post about extension projects versus adaption projects. It's all about how SAP is moving towards a more advanced way of customizing apps with adaption projects. The post explains how adaption projects, created in SAP Business Application Studio, lets you adapt apps without modifying the standard code. You get powerful new features, improved upgrade stability, and the flexibility to work with on any SAP app, not just legacy ones. It also compares the older extension projects to adaption projects, showing why adaption projects are the way forward and to give you a better idea of the differences between the two. If you're working with existing extension projects, don't worry, you can still use them, but SAP recommends migrating to an adaption projects for bigger or new requirements. To learn more about the blog post, it's linked below. And as always, happy coding!
Just in time for the year end, we are happy to share that the SAP Data and Analytics Advisory methodology is now officially available as part of the SAP Help documentation. The methodology provides a comprehensive framework for enterprise and data architects to evaluate data strategies, develop solution architectures, and foster a data-driven culture through a structured four-phase approach. This process is supported by a data domain reference model to establish a common understanding of CP data, a data and analytics capability model to enhance the architecture definition process, and data-driven use case patterns and reference architectures to accelerate solution architecture development. Use the holiday season as an opportunity to get inspired and set the groundwork for successful data and analytics projects in the coming year. And while we are on the topic, I'd like to highlight two product-specific resources from the respective product managers. The SAP DataSphere 2024 highlights, presented by KP Sauer, and the teaser for the Q4 release of SAP HANA Cloud, shared by Thomas Hammer. The links are in the description, as always.